If you aren't real comfortable with PID, or you want to learn how PID works in a Do More PLC, or you want to learn how to tune a PID loop in a Do More controller, or you just want to learn about all the cool tools Do More Designer has to help you with PID, then you're in the right place. And the good news is, we've broken it up into small, bite-sized chunks to make it easier for you to consume. This video is just a quick overview of what we'll be doing. The next video will review the hardware setup we'll use for this series of videos, and we'll manually run that hardware through its paces to get familiar with it. Now, I can't emphasize all of this enough. Fundamentally understanding your hardware and how it responds to changes is the most important step in getting PID to work. So we're going to spend an entire video just studying the hardware and pointing out the kinds of things you need to be aware of. In part 3, we'll learn how to properly use Autotune to quickly find the PID coefficients and optimum sample time, and we'll run some tests to see how well it works. There's a lot to cover there, so we broke that up into two parts. Now, wouldn't it be cool if you could build and test your PID code on a simulated system so you don't have to take your real system offline while you get it all figured out? Well, guess what? Do More Designer has a built-in PID process simulator that allows you to do exactly that. Build and test your PID system before you take your real system offline. We'll see how to use the PID process simulator in part 4. In part 5, we'll learn how to manually tune a PID loop using one of my favorite open loop tuning methods. This is a super stable and reliable way to quickly get the PID coefficients without taking your system down for long periods of time, and without having to play the PID guessing game where you just guess at coefficients until things sort of kind of work. We'll then compare these manual tuning results to the Do More's closed loop and open loop auto-tune results. Now, in all of these videos so far, we'll manually control the set point. In part 6, we'll use the ramp soak function as our set point, and we'll see how well a properly tuned PID loop can track that. Now, we aren't able to cover every little detail in these short videos, so we have one last video to revisit the things we glossed over or didn't get a chance to cover. And remember the end goal. Whatever the process is, temperature, flow, speed, pressure, position, etc., we want PID to get the system up to some set point value as quickly and accurately as possible, and to have it automatically hold that value until we tell it to go to another set point as quickly and accurately as possible. In this series of videos, we'll be using PID to control the temperature inside this enclosure, which we'll pretend is an oven that we want to maintain at 110 degrees Fahrenheit. Head on over to part 2 to get started with PID in a Do More enabled controller. Click here to see all the videos in this series. Click here to learn more about Automation Direct's free technical support options, and click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you'll be notified when we publish new videos.